Lots of both these amazing guys here. And for the worship, your time starts right now, right here.
So the moot question today here is whether Hartal is a hindrance to the progress of the state. Ladies and gentlemen, not even an iota of doubt that Hartal is not only a hindrance, but it is also a destruction of the progress of the state. As according to the report of Kerala Chambers of Commerce and Industry, Kerala faced incurred a loss of 7,200 crores because of the Hartal which we saw last year. Now, lives of the people suffered, people died because of the lack of emergency facilities at that point of time. Now, people's life and economy of the country came to a standstill, and it takes us two steps backward the progress which we have already taken. Now, when I talk about economy, I not only mention the corporates and the rich, but I also talk about the daily wage laborers who lose out their daily meals because of Hartal, which brings down the human development index of the country. Now, which is again in contradiction to the definition of progress which we are talking about. And Hartal curtails the liberty of a person, the movement of a person, which is in violation of Article 21 of the Constitution, and which is against the concept of liberty. Liberty is a process through which the country's people progress and their mentality increases. Now, when we talk about the process.
Thank you. Against the motion, yeah, 1 minute starts now.
Irrational are those people who say that progress should only be measured in the terms of economy. No, the concept of welfare state actually envisages that we take into consideration social progress through. Hartals are actually a unique tool in the hands of people to mobilize and organize and to make enough noises so that the one rules hears the needs of the layman as such. It's an indirect way of policy formulation. It is highly imperative in this globalized economy where we have active corporate lobbying and interfering illegitimately to form policies in their favor. What do the laymen do? The laymen require tools like Hartals where they can actually organize and actively bargain for their rights, direct descent toward the lobbying. And I would also like to say that our constitutional machineries unfortunately suffer a lot of lacunas, and one such being the cognitive biases of the judges towards high profile
lawyers. Thank you. Thank you so much. Your time up. Now we have 3 minutes for the debate, and your time starts now.
As I had already mentioned that I was not talking about the corporates, I was also talking about the human development index. So yes, that's a contradiction. Now the second thing is, we say Article 21A of the Constitution should promote education. When we have 100 days of Hartal a year, there are only 265 days left. So how do we educate our children? That is again a violation of Constitution. Now, as it is rightly mentioned in the Constitution by, in the case of Bharat Kumar versus the CPIM, that Hartal can be made, but the band is in violation of the Constitution. Say yes, that curtails our rights.
Yeah. Being lawyers, should we dig deep into the constitutionality of Hartals? We all know that it's constitution in the first place. Now let me draw to the next best examples of the SDGI index, which actually speaks that education wise and social security, gender equality, Kerala stands a state with high number of Hartals which stand first in the index. Therefore, there is a direct correlation between the number of Hartals that we are actually having and the growth that I envisaged, or we as laymen envisaged, that the social progress as such.
Okay, as he was talking about HDI index and Kerala, I would like to say how many industries are there in Kerala. We have to go outside the state once we are graduated. Why is that? Because nobody wishes to come to Kerala, because people come with flags and they protest, then go for Hartal. That's why it is a contradiction to the economic reforms.
No, my dear friend, it's actually an active check and balance against the tyranny of government. We only face public graft once in 5 years. How do we actually communicate our dissent, our wish to the government? It is only through the descent of Hartals that we show to the representatives who heartily turn up in our constituencies, except for the 5-year visit. This is actually a tool, that a powerful tool that the constitution has enshrined or vested in us, which we should be using at any cost.
Okay.
Yeah, so everyone was saying about Gandhiji and the Hartal which they brought, but then that was against the Britishers. But right now we are creating Hartal against our own state, against our own country, which is in violation of the constitution. Now when I talk about constitution, we have to talk about everyone. What about those laborers who lose out their daily meals because of Hartal? That should be thinked upon. Yes.
Please.
They might actually lose a day of work if for Hartal, but they will actually lose a lifetime if not for Hartal. Because Hartals are organized forces that are powerful enough to change the labor laws as such. If you're only concerned about the one day laws that you're suffering, you will be, for your life long, you will be concerned of the I mean, the multiple losses that you will be facing in terms of the oppressions of the government that are formulating policies to satisfy the rich and the corporates.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, you might feel face losses. Your political party which you are affiliated to might face political losses because they do not have any other football to play. So yes, they are playing with your lives. Do not say yes to Hartal, say no to Hartal, because it actually indirectly suffers, make you suffer.
Alright, your time up. Now you have 30 seconds each to conclude your statement. Before the motion, your time starts now.
And Hartal is actually a protest which is against the policies of the government, but right now what we are trying to do is, it is a football of political parties by which we are being played. So right now we should say no to Hartal, because it is not a form of constitutional right, I would say, because there is right now there is no difference between Hartal and the Band. People are forcefully shut down, they are made to not function in the offices, and that's again violation of Bharat Kumar versus CPI, and also the latest judgment which came in by the High Court which regulated the Hartal, that a 7-day notice period should be given. That is again.
Thank you. Against the motion, your 30 seconds starts now.
Careful analysis of Article 19(1)(a) and 19(1)(b), and also the Constitutional Assembly debates clearly shows that our constitutional makers clearly wanted to feel empowered, not as rotten brains, lifeless robots, but active citizens who actually think and dissent and try to question the rulers. And actually, Hartal is one such of a powerful tool. And I would like to state that when I support Hartal, I am not against the recent High Court judgment. Regularizing Hartal is completely fine, but ban it, you are taking away the heart
of
democracy.
Yeah, time out, both of you kindly come forward and shake your hands. So can we give them a big round of applause? That was yet another finale.